동안 생존의 단서를 찾아나서 다섯 예술가들의 이야기에 귀를 기울여 보시기 바랍니다.
We're seeking clues for future survival during the last couple of months. Good afternoon, my name is Lee Dae-young, I'm a curator. As I've entered my mid-40s, I've been dreaming more about time travel, and among my daydreams, the most vivid is me traveling back 40 years to meet my 7-year-old self. I was born in 1974 in a village that had more trees than people. There it was possible to walk at night by moonlight. We would wake up to the sound of roosters and walk to school accompanied by the sound of ravens calling and fell asleep to the lullaby of crickets. During the day we chased the singing cicadas and at night we chased the shining fireflies. In the summer we collected moss growing from the cracks in the rocks by the stream and in winter we would gather pine cones on the snow. The sound of rain falling in the forest and the raindrops dripping on our ceramic jars and on the roofs, we knew how to distinguish between these different sounds. In May, I received a proposal from SBS for this collaborative project under the theme The World We've Never Experienced, New Ways to Survive. Since I was already thinking more about the pandemic and the influence that human behavior had on nature, I thought that it was a good opportunity to look back and take a trip to retrace the ecological footprints of my home village. Over the decades, roads have spread out like nerve cells, taking people wherever their curiosities and desires would take them. I walked up the mountain and I saw that sounds had vanished. The walnut tree stood alone in silence as if its breath was taken out of its life. It seemed like a candle in the wind. Let's return to reality. These days, digital technology has taken over the entire world. Thanks to the development of GPS, satellites, and Google Earth, people have become gods looking down on the Earth with an omnipotent, omnipresent perspective. Satellite and aerial images show on a real-time basis how animals are fleeing from what used to be their habitat. Now destroyed due to human activities and the changing environment of Earth caused by rapidly increasing carbon emission. But somehow, despite all this, mankind is still reluctant to take its foot off the gas pedal. Maybe the problem is not that people are unaware, but that people are unable to empathize. Art, which can grow empathy because it surpasses all of these boundaries, may have a role to play here. Art cannot be a medical vaccine for us, protecting us from the virus, nor can it be a scientific solution to reverse global warming. However, it can act as a social and philosophical vaccine for humans to have empathy for values which are not visible to the eye, such as trust, solidarity, and wisdom. What is needed, ultimately, is the ability for us to feel that warm bond between humans and our planet. We must fight against the egoism of thinking only about me, only about humans, thereby recovering the emotional link that has been broken, and I have found the answer in sound. Even if it's not visible, sound delivers meaning, surpassing space and time. Sound enables us to imagine the textures of nature. I ask myself, what resonance can sound create in people? The power of sound was already experienced early this year at Connect BTS Berlin. Bill Fontana's work, the throbbing sound of the 3,000-year-old tree, sounding the beats of life, I still remember the thrill it sent through me. Considering that the Anthropocene epoch refers to a geological formation of man-made elements such as plastic, carbon, radioactivity, I imagine what a sound geological formation might be like. And with the participation of artist Kim Young-sun, who collected ecological, historical, and cultural sounds, Yuan, who researches anthropological relations of 10 Asian countries, composer Choi Woo-jung, whose work is identifying meaning in sounds and patterns, and Han Seok-hyun, who works with the themes of life and death of trees, we embarked on this amazing project for Mata, meaning to stop. For Mata, which you will view momentarily, breaks down the normal logical methods of sensing, so it will trigger a sense of discomfort. For those of you who are used to the long-established language and expression of mainstream media, it may seem somewhat rough, wild, and even bewildering. This project highlights the problem that exists in modern man's way of information input, where in the midst of this tsunami of information, we only take in what we want. And that has led to an inability to empathize, a loss of our senses. It has changed those senses for us. For our survival, it is now time to think hard about how to coexist in balance with the natural environment and not just focus on economic activity. It is time to consider the new survival conditions for mankind, not with a linear concept of time, but a circular one. And that is the only way we'll be able to listen again to the sounds of Earth, its breath, pulse, heartbeat, and its groans. The reckless exploitation of mankind has deepened the wounds of the Earth's surface and has taken the temperatures up to unprecedented levels. Excessive heat, rainstorm, earthquake, diseases. These are symptoms of an ailing planet. It's not too late to open our ears and listen. Listen to seek out traces of life that we may have ignored so far and to act to protect that life. Now let's take our feet off the accelerator pedal. Let's walk in place for a while. Stop and look around you. Touch the trees. Listen to the trees. It is only then that you can set your ecological imagination free. That is the new survival condition for mankind, and that is the future for mankind. Thank you.